No, 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 that's not the question. The question is that once railgate happens, you decide to settle political scores.
No, they're not
is it not sheer political vendetta on the part of the Congress, which holds considerable influence over what is called the Congress Bureau of Investigation, to use it selectively to settle political scores with rivals when they get out of the alliance? Today, the talk of town is Mr. Kamal Nath. I'm sorry, I'm being very direct with you today. I hope you don't mind. The talk of the town is Mr. Kamal Nath, that if you're not allied with the Congress Party, you are going to face a CBI case of some kind or the other. Look at Jagan Mohan.
Okay. Look at what Bansal was not aligned with the Congress Party. That's why the CBI took action against him. Are you suggesting that?
I am suggesting that when the case of Railgate came in, you brought in the name of Mamata Banerjee, which you were blind to when she was your ally.
If CBI is working at our directions, why would this Railgate ever have happened?
Well, I'm asking on Mamata Banerjee. May I ask you a counter question?
I answered Mamata Banerjee. If the investigative process has to look at past practices, and there is a distinction. The past practice was something else, the present practice was something else. Why not?
No, I can prove to you, Mr. Kamal Nath, that you've been selective as far as Mamata Banerjee is concerned. I'll prove to you. There was a member of parliament called Somen Mitra who wrote to the Prime Minister saying, Mr. Prime Minister, there's a terrible situation on the chit fund case. Other members of parliament wrote to the Prime Minister, wrote to others in the government on the chit fund case when Mamata Banerjee was in power. Nobody, Mr. Kamal Nath, and I assert nobody in the government looked at it, despite knowing that there could be ramifications of it, despite knowing that poor investors could be affected. It is only after Mamata Banerjee has now come out, and this scam has now come out, like in the case of Railgate, that you're opening up the files. And you would not have opened up the files if she was an ally of yours.
You have swept under the carpet. You have swept under the carpet a simple thing. When I said you were looking at past practices of the last 2-3 years where the Railgate is concerned, and that means targeting somebody. That means you should not look at in an investigative process past practices. Now, having swept that under the carpet, let me answer this one. Where the chit fund case was concerned, of course there was concern. The finance ministry was looking at
what
it.
What action?
But, no, you are inquiring. There are so many things which don't blow up. There are so many things which haven't emerged. They emerged later. Everything has a timing. You cannot foresee that this is what's going to emerge and this is what's going to evolve. So, as soon as it evolved in West Bengal. And I think it's had a tremendous political fallout also.
Well, political fallout, but you didn't act against your Mamata Banerjee when she was your partner.
How have we acted now?
You acted now because she's not your ally, and now you can afford to put the pressure on her. The moment she'll tie up with you again, you will forget all the suicides.
No.
Mr. Kamal Nath, I'm
finding it amusing. I'll tell you why. Because there were no suicides at that time happening when we never looked at it. It blew up now when there are suicides. It's blown up now because so much has been revealed.
Mr. Kamal Nath, the chit funds, you're from Calcutta, though your constituency is Chindwara, but you're from Calcutta and you know very well that in Bengal, this is not the first chit fund scam. There has been a chit fund scam in the left period as well. So you will be asked, why did you not consider the ramifications of it when she was in power? I don't want to keep arguing on the point, but would you agree that my central assertion to Mr. Kamal Nath that you act when it suits your political convenience is correct?
Certainly not. Nothing is dictated by political convenience. Let me say this very emphatically, and you can read whatever you want to read, but it's very clear that whatever has happened is happened in an emerging scenario. And the government acted. The central government immediately acted. First, the West Bengal government had to act because they are administered by the state government, as you know. And the West Bengal government was the first government which should have acted on it.
Mr. Kamal Nath, now, you know, this whole aggression on the BJP, on what is happening in Parliament, conveniently overlooks the fact that the Congress Party in the past has been far more, what was the word Sonia Gandhi used, obstructionist. Now, Sonia Gandhi says that the BJP has been obstructionist. It can easily be argued with facts that when you were in the opposition, you were far less cooperative, you were even more obstructionist than the BJP is today. So all this highfalutin talk and the, you know, about parliamentary practice sounds hollow, doesn't it, Mr. Kamal Nath?
I think it's totally inaccurate. I, for one, can say this because I have been in parliament. I'm not saying this from the outside, okay? Now, having said that, we cooperated with the BJP where it meant legislation which was for the country. What happened in the WTO legislation? What happened in the patent legislation?
That's right.
So many legislations which the BJP brought in. We have never obstructed the way the BJP is obstructed.
That's not true.
Parliamentary records will prove this.
That's not true.
You got your facts all wrong.
No, it's not.
Because I know the facts. We calculated the facts.
Yeah.
They are a matter of record.
They're not a matter.
And if you see, it's simple. You can go on the internet. You can go on the internet and all the viewers can go on the internet to see how many hours were disturbed in the previous Lok Sabhas when the BJP was in government.
Mr. Kamal Nath, you hold a record during the Tehelka expose. The Congress at that point of time did not allow the House to function for a full 17 days despite repeated BJP appeals. Having done so, and at that point as well, you know I'm right. Mr. Kamal Nath, you know I'm not wrong on fact. You know, you are
talking of 17 days.
17 days.
Do you know what has happened, what the BJP has done in this Lok Sabha, in this parliament, in the life of this parliament?
Were you open to a discussion on these critical issues of corruption and scam under the rules of 193-84 or calling?
Certainly. I stood on the floor of the house and it was on your channel. That I am willing to have any discussion on any subject under any rule in this house.
And
if the BJP, I told them that whatever you want to say outside, whatever you want to say in studios, please come and say on the floor of the house. You cannot stand in a studio or outside and say and run. So the BJP's philosophy was say and run without waiting. Nobody knows what the other answer is. So this policy, BJP adopted a policy that we will not let parliamentary democracy function. Please tell me one thing which they said to your channel, which they could not say on the floor.
Mr. Kamal Nath, let me ask you this. Do you believe that if a government comes out and tells the opposition, like you have done, that there should be a talk on 183, 984, 194, or calling attention on any issue, at that point of time, the opposition should relent? And if it does not, that it's being a... No, if it does not, then it's being an irresponsible opposition. Would you say so?
Parliament does
would
not...
Would you say so?
Parliament does not belong to the government.
No.
Parliament does not belong to the Congress Party.
So
Parliament belongs to all political parties and all members of Parliament. And so I asked you a question, that is there anything which was said which they couldn't stand on the floor of the house?
No, I'm asking, but you're not answering my question. My question to you is, if you're the government and I'm the opposition, and you turn to me and you say that have a discussion on a 183, 194 calling attention, any other provision that you want, voting, non-voting, on an issue of national importance, then I should actually give in. And if I don't give in, I'm being obstructionist, I'm being irresponsible.
It's not a question, don't give in. If you obstruct in Parliament, you say no, I will not. Parliamentary democracy entails discussion and debate.
Mm.
Why run away from it?
Why run away? So, Mr. Kamal Nath, that's exactly what I wanted you to come to. Let me remind you that on the 19th of March 2011, then Parliamentary Affairs Minister, someone you were closely acquainted with, Mr. Pramod Mahajan, stood and told journalists, quote, if the opposition won...
Which year was this?
Sir, 2001. I think this is just after the Tehelka expose. If you remember,
held
Parliament to ransom for 9 days initially, eventually 17 days over Tehelka. So at that point of time, Pramod Mahajan spoke your language. And Pramod Mahajan said, if the opposition wants, we are ready for a discussion under any rule, 193, 184, calling attention. I accept and honor that right. The government will accept the general consensus. Does it not seem strange to you, Mr. Kamal Nath, 12 years later, history has come back to repeat itself? Only it is Kamal Nath.
It was only 9 days.
My point is proven. My point is proven.
No, it's not proven. Not at all. Did the number of days this Lok Sabha has lost by obstruction by the BJP? Please tell me that. And compare it with the 2000. I say compare it with the Parliament in 2001. If you make that comparison, you will find this is minimal what has happened, what the Congress did.
I'm very sorry.
So you are not putting the facts.
No,
you have to put the facts,
Mr.
that Kamal Nath, how many days was it totally disturbed.
Mr. Kamal Nath, it's not about the number of days. It is about the attitude that you had then and the attitude that you're having now.
If the
attitude then was this. You went the other side.
No.
Mr.
No.
Kamal Nath, what happened?
If I disrupt for 3 days, if the BJP tells me we'll disrupt for 3 days, in a 2 month session, okay.
At least concede that after 33 years in Parliament, you can't turn around and say you don't remember because you were not in Parliament. Because I have the unique privilege of interviewing someone who's been in Parliament for 33 years. You can't run away from the facts. Mr. Kamal Nath.
That's why I know more about Parliament than what anybody does, including you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. But then you would also agree that ironically at that time, when there were irregularities or defence purchases made in Kargil, an issue on which Kamal Nath and Congress leaders went to town, you remember that?
Yeah.
At that point of time, the Congress was making the extremely strong pitch for a JPC scrutiny into the purchase of defence equipment and stalling Parliament. Am I right or wrong?
It's stalling for a day. Are you making a pitch that We should not have made that pitch.
No, I'm saying it because today you are complaining about the food security bill and the land acquisition bill not getting precedence.
It's not a bill of the Congress party. It's a bill being moved by the government for the people of this country.
I've heard that before. I've heard that before.
Do you know the content of the food security bill? Do you know the content of the land acquisition bill? It is something which the people of this country, for the land acquisition bill, farmers and so many other sections of society are waiting for.
Well, Mr. Kamal Nath, you don't have, I'm sorry to say this directly to you as the Parliamentary Affairs Minister of India, you don't seem to have, at this point of time, the determination to push the food security bill.
We have the determination for the food security bill and the land acquisition bill.
You have not reflected. You made it a political subject.
Yeah. And it's not political. We have never said it's political. In fact, I'm saying it's not a political issue. I'm saying the opposite. It's not a political issue. Others want to play politics with this.
The charge against you is that you want it to remain as a political issue in hibernation. The moment it is solved, you will not be able to milk the
Not at all. Not at all.
Because the public...
The people of this country will remember the Congress party for the food security bill and the land acquisition bill. For us, it is not. We don't want to keep it in hibernation. And the food security bill and the land acquisition bill will come.
Then tell me one thing. Let's talk Turkey, Mr. Kamal Nath. Are you bringing in a special session of Parliament on the food security?
I'm not ruling it out. I will have to talk to political parties. I'll have to get their sense of things. And today, there's not one political party you need to talk to. You must remember, see the numbers on the floor.
So don't avoid the question. Are you going to call? Because the talk is this, that between this session and the next, the Congress party is likely to call a special session of Parliament to corner the opposition on the food security bill and the land acquisition bill.
Let me answer this very categorically.
Yes, absolutely.
The food security bill and the land acquisition bill, the Congress party is determined to bring. We are not ruling out anything to bring this in.
What does, including a special session of Parliament?
Including a special session of Parliament.
Including a special session of
Parliament. We are not ruling out having a special session of Parliament for these two bills.
That means it's as good as happening.
No, it's not. I need to talk to political parties.
But you'll begin the discussion for that.
Yes, certainly I'll talk to them.
And you're saying this for the first time.
Well, I don't know whether I'm saying it for the first time, but I am saying it.
That's significant, Mr. Kamal Nath. Mr. Kamal Nath, final question to you. I have two or three questions for you. First of all, I appreciate your candor. At a point of time when several people in the Congress party don't want to take the questions, I appreciate the fact that you're taking my questions today. Mr. Kamal Nath, why are you using government money for Congress propaganda?
It's government's achievements. What did
government money for Congress propaganda?
What did the NDA do?
It is don't forget what the NDA did. I'm asking you what you did. You criticize India shining.
Your question should be, do you want to also do what the NDA government did? That should be your question. But anyway,
I have to counter this. The day a senior minister tells me what I should be asking, I assure you I will stop being a journalist.
I was assisting you in framing your question. Nevertheless, I want to put it clear. What we are publicizing is government's achievement. Because what the BJP and opposition parties have been talking about, misgovernance. And they are a party who don't understand governance, and they're talking about misgovernance. In the last 1 year or something like that, the BJP has lost two states.
That's
because
not
of misgovernance.
What I'm asking
no,
you.
Because governance does not happen on India Gate. No. Governance happens on the states. And the BJP has lost two states. Instead of having gained two states, they are losing states to misgovernance. And they stand here and they talk of governance.
Avoided my question completely.
I'm not avoided at all.
My question was this. Government scheme has the line which says, aapka paisa aapka haath.
Absolutely.
Right?
That's the Aadhaar.
Yeah, Aadhaar. Yeah. Direct cash transfer.
Yeah. People must know.
Isn't it strikingly similar to Congress ka haath aam aadmi ke saath? The imagery which you are using constantly is the Congress party symbol. Could you not coin another way of communicating without using the Congress party symbol to communicate the fact that you are giving money which brings back to the original question?
Money is in your hands. Can you translate in Hindi for me in a better way?
No, why do you have to say money is in your hand?
Because your hand means your heart.
Can't you say money goes directly to your bank account?
No, so we said
money goes directly
bank
to
bank account
you.
Is yours. So why you're saying money is coming in your hands. Now, if you say the hand happens to be the symbol of the Congress party, so I grudge it. So be it. I can't translate.
That's brazen.
I can't change the translation of a hand being a heart. If somebody can, please do tell me.
Mr. Kamal Nath, master of comebacks, you have been a master of comebacks. What is your secret ambition? Now I'll be very direct. A couple of years back, a lot of people said that after 30 years as a parliamentarian, Kamal Nath's political stock is down. He's a senior minister, but not at the level of seniority that a person of his experience should be getting. Now, Mr. Kamal Nath, you are the most visible face of the government and the party. What next?
I'm very happy where I am. I have no particular pursuit. I have no ambition. I have been in politics for a long time. I started as a youth worker, and I look at myself as continuing as long as I can.
Were you disappointed when you went through the rough times?
I was not. In fact, I was very relaxed, and I missed times when I'm more relaxed than what I am today.
The next ambition?
I wish I could have a sabbatical.
Mr. Kamal Nath, it's a pleasure talking to you. Thank you very much for opening up and speaking to me on Frankly Speaking. Thank you, Mr. Kamal. Thank you.
Tell us what you think about this episode of Frankly Speaking with Arnab Goswami. Write in to us and tell us who you'd like to see next on the show on this Twitter handle.